18 minutes away from 9 at breakfast all morning. We've been reporting a tsunami warning. Time now to get an update on that warning from Civil Defence. Joining me now is Civil Defence spokesperson Colin Feslier. Colin, good morning to you.
Good morning, Paul.
What is the latest?
Well, the latest is that we've got reports coming in from Samoa about damage, but at the moment we are classifying from a tsunami, but we are classifying those at the moment as rumour. We haven't got them confirmed.
We've spoken to people in Samoa, and it's much more than rumour. They're running for their lives, and they've seen people washed away.
Yes, that's the sort of reports that we're having too. Of course, often, sure. Of course, the same people.
I would give those a bit more credibility than rumour, though, Colin.
Well, we need to stick to facts. It appears that there has been a tsunami generator that's been confirmed by the warning centre. How big it is, how wide an area has been damaged, and to what extent, we don't know yet. We also don't know what intensity the tsunami will have when it reaches other land, including New Zealand.
All right. So when are you going to know anything?
I think over the next hour.
Well, that's no good for the people on the East Cape, because we've heard warnings that the tsunami is due on the East Cape. It will strike there first before 10 o'clock.
Well, I think that we're talking about a three-hour travel time between this tsunami and this generated tsunami and arrival at the closest point in New Zealand. So,
The times that we were given by the Tsunami Warning Centre was that the first it would strike would be East Cape at about 9:44, which is, ironically, in exactly 1 hour's time.
Everybody in a coastal area in New Zealand should be looking for looking towards their own safety.
Okay, what should they do?
They need to think, how will I get to higher ground?
Well, Colin, do they need to make for higher ground?
We have to rely on what their local civil defence people tell them in the local area to know that, but it is wise to look at the situation and to say, if I need to move, how will I move? What do I need to take with me?
All right, well, let's talk about the people on the East Cape then, who've been told that maybe in an hour's time the tsunami will strike. What do you reckon they should do?
I think that anybody in a vulnerable area should be looking to move to an area that is less vulnerable, but I think that they should take a lead from their local, the people who are in charge.
So do they have to ring? Do they have to? I mean, you know, it's civil defence. This is breakfast right around the country. A golden opportunity for civil defence to do something other than have meetings and eat croissant.
What our advice always is for people to listen for formal civil defence warnings, which are broadcast through the media, with which we've got arrangements to broadcast them, including your own when they're made, and that what people should do is they should act on that advice. Now, the point is that at the moment we don't know what manner of tsunami, if any, will hit New Zealand. We are still trying to confirm that tsunami of their nature.
Well, can I just say, Colin, you must be the slowest outfit in the country, because we have spoken on air already this morning to people who are running for their lives and have seen other people in Samoa swept away, and you are calling that rumour.
The confirmation of what actually has occurred in a disaster, you know as well as I do, Paul, that your initial reports in this sort of situation always have to be treated with caution. Everybody has to work towards what provides the maximum safety, but at the same time, you check things.
All right. We've just heard that people in Takaha have been told to move to higher ground. So the message, Colin, from you, and we have to remember, you are a spokesperson only. Obviously, you don't make policy or anything like that. But the message for people is contact your local civil defence. If not, maybe take matters into your own hands if you're in a coastal area, and move to higher ground.
And keep listening to your local radio stations. Keep an eye on all other sorts of news, information. Remember that the police are a key contact in terms of giving instructions. If somebody in authority like the police gives you an instruction, follow it.
All right, Colin Fesley, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Colin Fesley, a spokesperson for the Ministry of Civil Defence and Emergency Management. We are hoping we will speak to the Minister of Civil Defence before the end of the programme. It's 13 to 9.
We'll find out the very latest on the Samoa earthquake disaster when we come back. Don't go away.